we shall have a bhajan. Kindly repeat after me.
पिता तेरी वंदना करते हैं,
रिपीट,
तेरी वंदना करते हैं, जीवन तेरे चरणों में रखते हैं, जीवन तेरे चरणों में रखते हैं, हम तुझे प्यार करते हैं, प्यार करते हैं। पुत्र तेरी वंदना करते हैं, पुत्र तेरी वंदना करते हैं, जीवन तेरे चरणों में रखते हैं, जीवन तेरे चरणों में रखते हैं, हम तेरी वंदना करते हैं, आत्मा तेरी वंदना करते हैं, जीवन तेरे चरणों में रखते हैं, जीवन तेरे चरणों में रखते हैं, हम तुझे प्यार करते हैं, हम तुझे प्यार करते हैं, हम तुझे प्यार करते हैं,
हम तुझे प्यार करते
Dear friends, by now we are all aware of the unfortunate developments surrounding the arrest of our 83-year-old Jesuit, Father Stan Swami. He is now in jail for the last 18 days and his health condition is not very good. He suffers from Parkinson's and hearing disabilities. He uses hearing aid in both ears and is very frail. He can't even hold his cup of tea and can't even sign his name because of Parkinson's. There has been an unprecedented nationwide outrage from civil and political circles, international media, and even a United Nations Commission on Human Rights, which has called for Father Stan's release. We were completely let down on Friday, 23rd October, when his bail application was rejected. For a Stan's life epitomizes courage, commitment, and solidarity with the poor. All his life he has worked with the poor and for the poor. He lives the gospel message of bringing good news to the poor and the marginalized. For a Stan, Swami was arrested by the National Investigating Agency on 8 October in Ranchi and was brought to Taloja jail after being accused of being a member of the banned Maoist party and being involved in a conspiracy to instigate caste violence. To those of us who have known Father Stan, these claims are absurd. He's kind and soft-spoken man. To stand up and fight for justice and truth, no matter what religion, culture, and ethnicity one belongs to, that is the mantra of Father Stan. Father Stan was born in a village near Trichy in Tamil Nadu. He's a member of the Jamshedpur Jesuit province. He worked as the director of Indian Social Institute, Bangalore, then was the director of Jharkhand, the Organization for Human Rights, known as Joha, a Jesuit social center in Chaibasa, Jharkhand, which works among the Ho tribes. In the year 2000, he moved to Ranchi, where he founded a new social center known as Bagicha, which continues to work for the rights of tribals in central India. Father Stan Swami is an intellectual. He has used the legal system to fight relentlessly for the rights of indigenous people. His work with Jharkhandis has provided a solid orientation and source of commitment to numerous intellectuals and community-based grassroots movements working to bring about social change. Father Stan has authored many books, especially about Adivasi rights and how they have been violated by the powers that be. Father Swami's relentless fight against displacements and violations of Adivasi rights by the government and corporate houses has made it difficult for some corporates to further their interests. Consequently, there have been continuous efforts by the powerful to silence him. Father Stan Swami is the oldest and the most recent victim under the draconian Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, UAPA, being accused of having links to the banned CPI Maoist groups. We pray today for justice for all the 16 human rights activists who were also arrested in this case, and for all other human rights activists who side with the poor and the marginalized. We pray for their safety, well-being, and speedy release. May God be with them.
प्रिय बंधू आणि भगिनींनो, तुम्ही मला ऐकत आहात, शुभ संध्या. आणि मी आणि आमचे धर्मगुरू आणि ब्रदर्स एकत्र जमलेलो आहोत या तीर्थक्षेत्री बाळ येशूच्या नाशिक येथे. आणि अशासाठी आम्ही जमलेलो आहोत की 8 ऑक्टोबरला आपल्या देशात एक काळा दिवस असा उगवला. तुम्हा सर्वांना टीव्हीवरती, वृत्तपत्रामध्ये किंवा इतर ठिकाणाहून माहिती असेल की 8 ऑक्टोबर 2020 रोजी एक जेझुइट फादर स्टॅन स्वामी, वय वर्ष 83, यांना नॅशनल इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन एजन्सी तर्फे देशाच्या अटक करण्यात आली. त्यांच्याविषयी थोडीशी माहिती हवी, ही अटक त्यांना का झाली आणि त्यांना मुंबईतील तलोजा या कारागृहात झारखंडवरून आणलेलं आहे. तुमच्या मनात अनेक प्रश्न असतील, शंका असतील की एका ख्रिस्ती धर्मगुरूंना जो चांगलं मिशन कार्य करत आहे आदिवासींमध्ये, का अशांना अटक व्हावी, कारण काय असावीत वगैरे. आता हे 83 वर्षीय फादर कंपवाताने आजरी आहेत, पार्किंग्सन. आणि जानेवारीमध्ये त्यांचा हातही फ्रॅक्चर झाला. जणू काही ख्रिस्तालाच आणत आहेत तुरुंगामध्ये, असं एकंदरीत ते वातावरण पाहून बरेचसे लोक हळहळलेले आहेत. देशात तर आहेतच, परंतु संपूर्ण जगामध्ये ही क्रूर चष्टा चाललेली आहे का, म्हणून अनेकांचे प्रश्न आहेत. हे फादर जमशेदपूर जेझुइट प्रॉव्हिन्समध्ये दाखल झाले आणि गरिबांच्या ओढ्याने, शेतकऱ्यांवरती होणाऱ्या अत्याचाराने ते व्यथित झाले. त्यांनी पाहिलं की येशूचा जो क्रूस आहे, वधस्तंभ आहे, तो त्यांनी शेतकऱ्यांच्या खांद्यावरचा नागर पाहिला आणि त्यांचे ते निर्धळाचे घामाचे कष्टाचे सगळं कार्य पाहून ते हळहळले. आणि त्याने खऱ्या ख्रिस्ताच्या मिशन कार्याला तिथे सुरुवात केली. मूळचे तामिळनाडूतील त्रिची गावचे आणि गेली 50 वर्ष ते ह्या आदिवासींबरोबर कार्य करत आहेत. आता तुम्हाला वाटेल की आदिवासींमध्ये तर कितीतरी मिशनरी काम करतात, मग यांनाच का अटक व्हावी. त्याला कारण आहे. कारण असं आहे की ज्या आदिवासींच्या शेतकऱ्यांच्या ज्या जमिनी आहेत, त्या धनवान विकत घेऊ पाहतात आणि त्यांना असंही सांगण्यात आलेलं आहे आदिवासी शेतकऱ्यांना की त्या खालचं जे खनिज आहे, खनिज ते देखील त्या धनवानांचं, जो जमीन विकत घेईल त्यांचं. परंतु स्टँड स्वामी उभे राहिले न्यायालयात, सुप्रीम कोर्टात, आणि त्याने सांगितलं नाही, ती फक्त त्यांची जमीनच नव्हे तर ते आतमध्ये जे खनिज आहे ते सुद्धा त्यांचंच आहे, शेतकऱ्यांचंच आहे. आता सांगा, असा न्याय मिळाल्यानंतर श्रीमंत धनिक लोक, व्यापारी लोक कुठल्या तऱ्हेने त्या आदिवासी शेतकऱ्यांकडे पाहणार. साहजिकच त्यांनी त्यांना त्रास द्यायला सुरुवात केली आणि त्यांच्यासाठी स्टँड स्वामी उभे राहिले. ही धनवानांसाठी आणि श्रीमंतांसाठी एक अडचण. यांना जर आपण बाजूला काढलं नाही, या मिशनरीला, या ॲक्टिव्हिस्टला, या समाजसेवा करणाऱ्यांना, तर आपला डाव साध्य होणार नाही. हे त्याच्या पाठीमागचं मुख्य कारण आहे. त्यामुळे फादर स्टॅन आणि इतर 8 जण मला वाटते असे सर्वजण, त्यांच्यावरती हा आरोप आहे. म्हणजे सोशल ॲनालिसिस जर आपण केलं, सामाजिक विश्लेषण जर आपण केलं, तर नक्की कारण काय आहे? धनवानांना रांचीसारख्या सुपीक जंगलामध्ये जल, जंगल आणि जमीन ही घ्यायची आहे. परंतु ते स्पष्ट कारण करून त्यांना अटक करता येत नाही म्हणून असं कारण लावून त्यांना अटक केलेली आहे. आणि त्यांच्यावरती आरोपी असा आहे की तुमच्याकडे नक्षलाइट्स, माओवादी ही पुस्तकं आहेत. आमच्या फादरांनी तर त्यांना दाखवलं की मी एकच पुस्तक लिहिलेलं आणि ते आदिवासींच्या हक्कासाठी लिहिलेलं आहे, ते तुम्ही पहा. आता कुठल्या लायब्ररीमध्ये दुसरी पुस्तकं असणार नाहीत? आता मी लायब्ररी चालवतो आमच्या नाशिकला, कॅथलिक आश्रममध्ये, होली क्रॉसमध्ये, टिळक वाचनालय, त्याच्यातही पुस्तकं आहेत. म्हणून का अटक करायची का? हा सगळा हास्यास्पद प्रकार आहे आणि सगळं जग शासनाला हसत आहे. एका 83 वर्षीय वृद्ध फादरांना, जे आजारी आहेत, त्यांना अशा प्रकारची अटक होणे, मित्रांनो, 144 कलम लागू आहे देशात करोना कारण, करोना आजाराच्या कारणामुळे, महामारीच्या कारणामुळे. त्यामुळे आवाज उठवण्यासाठी आपण रस्त्यावर येऊ शकत नाही, कारण संविधानाने, महात्मा गांधीजीने आपल्याला तो हक्क दिलेला आहे सत्याग्रहाचा. समता, बंधुता, एकता, न्याय, स्वातंत्र्य तुम्ही मागू शकता. फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच अँड फ्रीडम ऑफ रायटिंग, आपल्याला बोलण्याचा हक्क, लिहिण्याचा हक्क दिलेला आहे. परंतु तोही, त्याच्यावरतीही बंदी आहे. म्हणून मित्रांनो, सरते शेवटी आपली शक्ती प्रार्थना आहे, मग ते कुठल्याही धर्माची असो. अनेक लोक फादरांसाठी प्रार्थना करत आहेत आणि त्यानिमित्ताने फादरांना त्या तुरुंगवासामध्ये हे सर्व सहन करण्याची परमेश्वराने शक्ती द्यावी. त्यांच्या आजारपणात, अशक्तपणामध्ये त्यांचा सांभाळ करावा म्हणून आज या ठिकाणी आपण प्रार्थना करीत आहोत त्यांच्यासाठी.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory be to you, Lord.
Look, I am sending you out like sheep among wolves. You must be clever as snakes and gentle as doves. Be on your guard with regard to people, for they will hand you over to their courts and they will flog you in their synagogues. You will be brought to trial before rulers and kings because of me, as a witness to them and the Gentiles. But when you are arrested, do not worry about what you are to say or how you are to say it. When the hour comes, you will be given what you are to say. For it will not be you who speak, but it will be the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters and brothers, the Gospel passage that we have taken from the Gospel of Matthew is from the mission discourse. Jesus is sending disciples on a mission. He has given them a mission to drive away demons, heal the sick, stand for justice, speak the truth. And then he gives them instructions, he cautions them, saying, when I am sending you out like sheep among wolves, you must be clever as snakes and gentle as doves. Jesus says, when you are out in the mission, you will be facing varieties of people, administration, different people in authority. But what we are called to do is to bear witness to the values of the kingdom, to Christ, and in the context of our country, to our constitutional values, which are so very well written in the preamble. Equality, fraternity, freedom, justice. Now these are the values that we stand for when we read in the scriptures and the invitation that we have for the mission that the Lord has given us. And while on this mission, we would never know whom we will be facing or challenged by. And now one such case that we have of a missionary is Father Stan Swamy. He felt called. He moved into the missions. And we know well by now the mission that he did with the tribals, fighting for their rights, for their land rights. And what happened with authorities when he challenged their ways of proceeding. But the beauty of this passage is, he says, when you are arrested, that is the term that is used, word that is used, when you are arrested, fear not. Because what you are to say or how you are to say will be given to you, and that will be by the Spirit of the Father who will speak through you. And one more beautiful thing is, even at the cost of your life, even when there is danger so very clear waiting before you, there is no quitting whatsoever. When we stand for justice, when we stand for truth, we don't back out. We don't give up. Because mission comes first. And that mission is given to us by our Lord Jesus Christ. And we are faithful to that invitation. We are faithful to that call. And therefore, we don't give up. We have heard the video released by Father Stan, how he speaks of what he has done and how faithfully, how truthfully he has gone about. And there is courage in his words. Nowhere in his statements, in the videos that he has released, would you find him frightened of anything. There is no fear whatsoever of any sort, because he knows he is standing for justice, standing for these people who cannot voice out, or perhaps strategically silenced by authorities, administrations and laws and policies perhaps. But then he stood for them and he's standing strong. Today especially as we pray for him and pray for so many others who have voiced out against the injustices done. We have Varavara Rao, Vernon Gonsalves, Sudha Bharadwaj and so many others who are detained and are unjustly prosecuted. We stand for these people, we stand with these people through our prayers in all that we can. In some places we have seen the demonstrations happening, silent protests. We stand with our people who have stood for justice. Because when we stand by them, stand for them and stand with them, we will stand with the multitudes of people who are seeking justice today in their lives, who are seeking truth, who are seeking meaning in all that is happening. So we pause for a while and pray for all these freedom fighters that we have in today's context, the prophets who are voicing out the struggle for justice and truth, that the Lord may really open the eyes of all those who have been blinded by vested interests, that these people may be released soon and all of us may experience freedom through the freedom of these people. Amen.
We shall now have the intercessory prayers. Your response will be from Tagore's hymn, "Into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake." I'll sing it for you, and you will sing it after each intercession. Into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake. Sing it with me. Into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake.
For solidarity among the global human family, as we work together with all people of goodwill to end the suffering that is brought about due to oppression, violence, and war, grant us the strength and courage to be witnesses to your merciful love and charity. We pray to the Lord.
Into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake.
For our nation, the government officials and the leaders, give each one the grace to make decisions that are wise and towards the welfare of all. Make them firm to stand on issues that truly matter. May wisdom and integrity lead our nation in the right direction. We pray to the Lord.
Into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake.
For those who are challenged by the pandemic, people who grieve the loss of family members and friends, struggling with depression and anxiety due to loss of investments and jobs, may they find strength and support to continue their own life's journeys. We pray to the Lord.
Into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake.
Hey Deva, तुझ्यापेक्षा जास्त अन्यायाची खोली कोणालाही ठाऊक नाही. तुला अनेकदा अन्याय आणि अपमान सहन करावा लागला, तरीही तू सर्व आमच्या तारणासाठी सहन केलेस आणि आम्हाला तारण मिळवून दिलेस. तसेच न्याय मिळवून देण्यासाठी झटणाऱ्या सर्व मानवी हक्काच्या कार्यकर्त्यांकरिता आम्ही आज प्रार्थना करतो. आम्ही आज विशेष प्रार्थना करतो फादर स्टॅन स्वामी, सुधा भारद्वाज, अरुण फरेरा, वर्नन गोन्साल्विस, वरावरा राव, गौतम नवलखा, सुरेंद्र गंडलिंग, शोमा सेन, महेश राऊत, सुधीर ढवळे आणि रोना विल्सन ह्यांच्यासाठी ह्या सर्वांना योग्य न्याय मिळावा व त्यांचे संघर्ष अधिक बळकट व्हावे म्हणून आम्ही प्रार्थना करतो.
Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake.
आपले युवक हे आपल्या शहर, देश आणि जगाचे भविष्य आहेत. हे पवित्र आत्म्या, आमच्या तरुणांना आध्यात्मिक सामर्थ्याने भर. पालक आणि तरुणांची अंतकरणे एकमेकांकडे वळव. आमच्या तरुणाच्या मनाला स्पर्श कर आणि सर्व युवकांमध्ये समाजात होणाऱ्या असामाजिक घटनेबद्दल अधिक जागरूकता व्हावी आणि अन्यायविरुद्ध ह्या लढ्यात त्यांनी एकमेकांना सहाय्य करावे आणि समाजात एक बदल घडवून आणावा म्हणून आपण प्रार्थना करूया.
Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake.
हे दयाळू प्रदात्या, शेतकरी आणि त्यांच्या पिकावर आशीर्वाद आण. विशेषतः अशा असुरक्षित सुरक्षितेच्या वेळी सर्वत्र शेतकरी नैराश्याने खचून गेले आहेत. त्यांच्या प्रयत्नांना यश दे, त्यांचे संरक्षण कर म्हणून आम्ही तुमच्याकडे प्रार्थना करतो.
Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake.
Today, we pray for Father Stan Swami and many, many others who are in prison waiting for justice. What is the crime? To speak or to stand for truth. To empower the weak, the helpless. To speak for those who have lost their voice or nobody hears their voice. Empowering the downtrodden, the weak, the poor. Is it a crime? If it is so,
then the arrest of all these people is justified. We pray to God. We pray to Jesus. It is only He who leads us to the truth, the whole truth. Let's pray silently for these men who are in prison. For years, they served humanity. Nobody complained. All of a sudden, they look like criminals. Why? We don't know. We pray. God, give us men. A time like this needs strong minds, great hearts, true faith, and ready hands. Men whom the lust of office does not kill. Men whom the spoils of office cannot buy. Men who possess opinions and a will. Men who have honor. Men who will not lie. Men who can stand before a demagogue and damn his treacherous flatteries without winking. Tall men, sun-crowned, who live above the fog, in public duty and in private thinking. Lord, hear our prayer. In this beautiful country of ours, let there be true peace, justice, and truth.
Senses Let us pray. O God, in this wonderful sacrament, have left us a memorial of your passion. Grant us, we pray, so to reverence the sacred mysteries of our body, of your body and blood, that we may experience within ourselves the fruit of our redemption, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
The divine praises. Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels and his saints.
Sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine, O sacrament. Sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving.